Hey, what's going on, people? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to explain if statements, else if statements, and else statements in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running.
Alright people, let's talk about if statements. An if statement is a block of code that will execute only if its condition is true. It's a very basic form of decision making with programming. For this example, let's create a prompt where we will ask a user for their age, and depending on what their age is, we will print a response. So let's say age equals input, and then we will add a prompt. How old are you? Now this will return a string, so we should probably cast this as an integer data type. So we now have a variable called age where we will accept some user input. Let's check somebody's age with a variety of if statements. So let's check to see if somebody's age is greater than or equal to 18. So to create an if statement, type if and then some sort of condition. If age is greater than or equal to 18, to finish this if statement, add a colon at the end. Now pay attention to this. If I move down to the next line, you'll notice that my cursor is now indented. Any indented code underneath an if statement is the block of code for that if statement. So if this condition is true, we will execute some block of code. If it's false, we'll skip over it. So if somebody's age is greater than or equal to 18, let's print you are an adult. And let's try this program. How old are you? Let's say I'm 21. So my condition, when we get to the if statement, is going to check to see if this condition is true. If it is true, we're going to execute this block of code. If it's not, we skip over it. So how old are you? Let's say I'm 21. I'm going to hit enter and my if statement is true. So we execute this block of code, which prints you are an adult. So what if this condition is false? Let's say I'm 12. Well, then we're just going to skip over this block of code and continue on with the rest of the program. If you would like your program to take some other course of action, if this condition is false, we can add an else statement. So after the if statement, add else. Make sure you get the indentation right. You don't want this within the block of code for the if statement. So if this condition is false, we can take some other course of action. So if somebody's age is less than 18, let's print you are a child. So let's try this again. I'm going to enter that I am 12 years old. Not really, but let's just pretend I am. So this will now print you are a child. If this condition is false, perform this block of code for the else statement. So with if statements, we can check more than one condition before reaching the else statement by using an else if statement, and we add that after an if statement. So it's shortened to ELIF for else if. So let's check to see if somebody's age is less than zero for some reason. So let's print you haven't been born yet. So with if statements, we start at the top. We first check the if statement. If this is false, we move down to the next statement to check. Then we check our else if statement. If this is also false, then we resort to the else statement. The else statement is sort of like a last resort. If all conditions evaluate to be false, then we execute the else statement. So let's try this. How old are you? Let's say I'm negative 1 year old. You haven't been born yet. So with if statements, we always begin with an if statement and we check that condition. If that condition evaluates to be false, then we will skip this block of code and move down to the else if statement. If there is one, it's optional. If this condition is also false, then we will use our else statement as a last resort if there is one. If there is no else statement, then we just skip over all of this then and continue on with the rest of the program. So you can add more than one else if statement. So let's check something else. Let's check to see else if age is equal to 100. So if you need to check to see if a value is equal to a particular value, make sure you use double equal signs. This is the comparison operator for equality. If you use just one equal sign, that's the assignment operator, and Python thinks you're attempting to set age equal to 100. So if you want to check to see if age is equal to 100, then use double equals. So let's check to see if somebody's age is equal to 100. So let's print, you are a century old. Now pay attention to this. If I were to run this program, how old are you? Let's say I'm 100. So this is printing, you are an adult. That's because we first check our if statement, and well, we're 100 years old, and 100 is greater than or equal to 18. So we print this block of code, we execute this block of code, and then we skip everything else, even though age is equal to 100 within our else if statement. So the order of your if statements does matter. So let's change this around. Let's add this to the very beginning. And this will be our if statement, and we will set age is greater than or equal to 18 to be an else if statement. So we're first going to check to see if age is equal to 100. If not, we will check to see if age is greater than or equal to 18. And we just follow that order. So let's try this again. How old are you? I am 100 years old. You are a century old. So we first check our if statement. If this condition is true, we will execute this block of code. If it's false, we just go down the order till we reach our else statement. Well, everybody, that is the basics of if statements. We have if statements, else if statements, and else statements. So if you would like a copy of this code, I will post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that is how if statements work in Python. Hey you, yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.